The Iron Warriors were some of the Emperor's finest siege troops, cold-hearted and relentless masters of war, but now can be found destroying what they once helped build. Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're showing you how to paint a legionnaire in the colours of the Iron Warriors, so grab your brushes and shake your paints and let's get started. Now the first thing that we need to do is undercoat the model, and as you can see here I have used Chaos Black. Now we can start with the metal armour, so we're going to be base coating it in Iron Warriors and then any other little metal details we'll be using Iron Hand Steel. So let's get on with the Iron Warriors first. So we're going to dip into the pot, we're going to need quite a bit of this because we need to cover quite a lot of armour. And now it's kind of thick, so I'm just going to thin it down with a touch of water, just make sure it's a nice smooth consistency. And now we can start applying it to our model. Now we're going to avoid the shoulder pads because we want those a dark colour. So we're just going to focus onto the legs and the arms and the main body. And you may need a couple of coats of this colour. And now that our Iron Warriors is now dry, we can move on to the Iron Hand Steel. And we'll start applying that to any other metallic areas that we want. So I'm going to apply it to the helmet, to the studs on the shoulder pad, to any cables as well that you can find. You might find that you need another couple of layers of this paint as well. And with those base coats now dry, we can move on to the shading. For this, we'll be using Agratha shade over the armour, and then Nun Oil over the lighter metal details. So let's get on with the Agratha shade. So, just going to dip into the pot. I'm going to take a little bit off to the top of the pot. So I just don't have too much on my brush, but I have enough to go into the armour. So let's go straight into that armour. So we're going to just make sure that it kind of goes into the recess areas around the kneecaps and any joints, but we don't want it to pool as it will go a little bit streaky. If it does start to pool, don't worry, you can slowly move it around while it's still wet. And now that the Agrax Earth shade is now dry, we can move on to the Nun Oil. So for this, we'll be applying it all over the silver details, and also we'll be applying it to the recesses of the armour, just to give it a little bit more depth. And with those shades now dry, we can move on to the other base coats. For these, we'll be using Abaddon Black for the shoulder pads and black details. Then we're moving on to the Hazard Stripes, and we'll be using Avalon Sunset to block that out. Then taking a HB pencil to mark those out, and then using Corvus Black for the black parts of the hazard stripes, and then we'll be finishing off with Mephiston Red for the lenses. So let's get on with the Abaddon Black. So we're going to take it out of the pot. It's quite a little bit thick, and we're going to take a little bit more out, and we'll thin it down with a touch of water. And we won't get too much on our brush, so I'm going to take a little bit of that off, and then we can start applying it to our black details. So for this, we'll be just covering the shoulder pads just in case we've got any streaks or metal bits on those. And then we'll be using it on the gun casing and on the joints of the armour between the plates. And with that black dry, now we can move on to the Avalon Sunset. And for this, we're going to make the hazard markings on this nice leg plate. So I'm going to start around, just around this side here. I'm going to use this bottom corner of the pauldron to mark out where we're going to start. Just take your time, and you may need a few thin coats of this just to make sure you get a nice solid colour. Now that the yellow is now dry, we can start off with the markings. So we're going to take our pencil and we're going to start with the notch just on this leg plate here as our starting area. And we're going to work our way all the way up to this part on the leg. So that is going to make it a lot easier for us to mark out where we're going to go. And with our pencil markings now down, we're going to fill in some of those chevrons with some Corvus Black. We're going to be nice and neat as we can, so I'm going to start with this corner here, and then do every other one. And you can always tidy up the yellow chevrons with some of the Avalon Sunsets like before. And now that our hazard stripes are nice and neat, we can move on to the Mephiston red for the lenses. So we're just going to be nice and careful and neat, because they are quite small. You might want another layer, just make sure the paint's nice and thin. And with those lenses done, now we can move on to highlighting. We'll be starting off with some Ironbreaker, and we'll be highlighting the metal armour and finding some chippings on there as well. So I'm going to dip into the pot of the Ironbreaker. It's quite a little bit thick for a layer paint, so I'm just going to thin it down with a touch of water. Just make sure our brush is into a lovely point. And then we can start applying it to our armour. So we'll be starting off by just chipping away around some of the edges. You can make sure that it's a little bit rougher than normal when you're edging. And then you can do it onto the metal plates and over the hazard stripes as well. Now that the Ironbreaker is now dry, we can move on to the other highlights. For these, we'll be using Skaven Blight Dinge and Eshin Grey for the black armour, and Evil Sun Scarlet and Fire Dragon Bright for the lenses. So let's get on with that Skaven Blight Dinge. So we're going to just dip into our pot like normal. I'm going to get it onto our palette. I'm going to thin it down because we need it nice and smooth. I'm going to get our brush to a lovely point, and then we can start putting it on the black. So we're going to make sure that we're going to be nice and careful with this, because we don't want to go back onto those chippings, but we need a nice coverage. You may find that you want to give another layer just in case, and we'll do the gun casing as well as any other black details. Now that first highlight is now dry, we can move on to our edge highlight of Eshin Grey. So we're just going to take it onto the finest points of the pauldrons and the shoulder pads and on the gun casings, but we don't want to cover all of that first highlight. Now with the black armour finished, we can move on to those eye lenses. So I'm going to use Evil Sun Scarlet just to go onto the bottom part of the lens, just to give it a little bit more colour. Now that Evil Sun Scarlet is now dry, we can use the Fire Dragon Bright to make dots on the lenses. Now that our highlights are all finished, we can move on to some effects. So for this, we'll be using a rust effect, and we'll be using Scrag Brown, thinned down with Larmium Medium. So we're going to take two parts Larmium Medium. Now I'm going to just wash off my brush and dry it off, and then I'm going to take one part Scrag Brown. I'm going to thin that down just so it's a little bit looser, so it rolls into those areas nicely. So let's start putting that in. So we're just going to put it around the rivets and anywhere that you would probably think that would be nice and rusty. So some areas of the gun and any joints would be quite cool to look at as well. You can also add little drips down as well if you just pull it down slightly. And with the rust dry, we can move on to the base. We'll be applying Armageddon Dust and then applying a shade of Seraphim Sepia on top. So we're just going to get our texture tool, and then we're going to scoop up some from the lid so we get a nice amount on there. And then we'll be a start applying it to the bottom of the base. And don't worry if you get onto the greaves, that looks quite nice with an effect of getting dust everywhere. And remember, it may take up to an hour for it to dry. Now that the texture is dry, we can apply a Seraphim Sepia shade over it. We're going to make sure that it doesn't pool too heavily in areas, but we want to give it some nice depth in those areas. Now that the shade is dry, we can move on to the dry brushing. For this, we'll be using Talon Sand for our first dry brush, and then finishing off with a lighter dry brush of Screaming Skull. So we're going to dip into the pot with the Talon Sand, and then we're going to take off a majority of the paint and the water out of the paint. So we're going to just scrunch it up onto our piece of paper. I'm going to make sure that we've got a good amount. Now we can start applying it over the texture. So we're going to just do it in small brush strokes, avoiding any of the recesses where we can, but don't worry if you do get into it, some nice texture to add to the base. And you can also dry brush onto the boots as well to give it a little bit more of a dirty effect. Now that our first dry brush is dry, we can move on to the Screaming Skull. And we're going to be a lot lighter with this just to catch those raised areas. And now with the base done, all there is left to do is to paint the rim in a colour that matches the rest of your army. And here we have used Steel Legion Drab. With the base complete and the rim painted, our Legionnaire is ready to join his brothers in the fight for Chaos and the Warmaster. So just a few things to remember while you're painting. When doing hazard stripes, use your lighter colour as your base first, so when you're doing your pencil markings, you can see them a lot clearer. And when using shades, don't worry if they pool up too much in some areas, you can always use a clean brush to dab those up. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoy painting your own Horus Heresy Legionnaires, and we'll see you soon. Bye bye!